Everything you need to know about potentiometers. Before the age of digital sensors and touchscreens, one small device was used mainly for manual control, the potentiometer. From turning up the volume on your favorite radio to adjusting brightness and tuning circuits, potentiometers, also known as pots or knobs, have been shaping our analog world for more than a century. What is a potentiometer and how does it work? A potentiometer is a variable or adjustable resistor, a three-terminal device that lets you manually adjust resistance in a circuit by rotating or sliding a contact across a resistive track. They are usually represented as a resistor symbol and an arrow touching it, representing the adjustable wiper. For variable resistors used in current control, like fan speed, only two terminals are used, the wiper and one end terminal. When you turn the knob, the wiper slides along the resistive track, changing the resistance between the terminals. As the shaft or slider moves, the voltage changes, giving a direct, reliable measurement of rotation or linear motion. Let's visualize how a potentiometer works at a deeper level. Let's look at a curved resistance track, a continuous strip of carbon or conductive plastic. We connect one end of the track to the positive side of a voltage source, and the other end to ground. That means the full supply voltage appears across the entire length of the resistive element. Now we have the wiper, a small metal arm that slides along that track. Wherever the wiper sits, it divides the total resistance into two sections. R1, from the top terminal to the wiper. R2, from the wiper to ground. And together, they always add up to the total resistance of the potentiometer. At this point, the potentiometer becomes a voltage divider, and this is where Ohm's law comes in. Ohm's law tells us, meaning the voltage across any resistor is the current flowing through it multiplied by its resistance. Because R1 and R2 are connected in series, the same current flows through both of them, so the voltage drops across each section in proportion to its resistance. The larger the resistance, the larger the voltage drop. The smaller the resistance, the smaller the drop. And this proportional dropping of voltage is exactly what gives us the voltage divider equation. Since R2 is the section between the wiper and ground, the voltage at the wiper, our output voltage, is equal to the voltage drop across R2. So, we apply Ohm's law to that section. But the total voltage across both resistors is, if we divide V out by V in, the currents cancel out because it's the same current in both resistors, leaving us with the ratio. Multiply both sides by V in and we get the voltage divider formula. This is essentially how a potentiometer works. So if the wiper sits closer to the top terminal, R2 is large, the ratio is large, and V out is close to V in. Moved the wiper toward ground, R2 becomes smaller relative to R1, and Vout drops smoothly toward zero. But keep in mind, potentiometers may look sturdy, but they're actually low-power components. Most, not all, are only rated for a quarter watt or half watt, and pushing too much current through them can burn the resistive track or create dead spots. If you're enjoying this deep dive into how potentiometers work, then make sure you hit that subscribe button and give us a thumbs up. We've got plenty more engineering explorations to come. You can also check out our online store for engineering-themed gear and tools that help support the channel. Every purchase genuinely helps us keep making high-quality content. And if you want to take things a step further, consider becoming an Engineeringness member. You'll get early access to new videos, behind-the-scenes content showing how we animate and build these breakdowns, and access to our member-only chat rooms where we talk about all things engineering. Before we jump back in, a huge thank you to Unikeyic for sponsoring today's video. If you're working on electronics projects or sourcing components for your next build, check out Unikeyic, a leading distributor of high-quality electronic components with over 200,000 items in stock and more than 10 million parts available. Use the link below to get 5% off your first order, up to $500. Now, back to the video. Anatomy of a potentiometer. Inside the housing, the main first part you'll find is the resistive track. This is the curved or straight strip that gives the potentiometer its total resistance between the two end terminals. It's usually made from carbon, cermet, or a conductive plastic material bonded to an insulating substrate. The material, track geometry, and mechanical design all influence how the potentiometer feels when you turn it, whether it's smooth, slightly gritty, or very precise. Resting on top of that track is the wiper. This is a small, springy metal contact that physically moves along the resistive surface. When you twist the knob or slide the fader, the wiper shifts position, tapping into a different point on the track. That movement is what changes the resistance seen at the wiper terminal, and therefore the output voltage in a voltage divider setup. To make that movement possible, there's a rotor or slider mechanism. In a rotary potentiometer, the wiper is attached to a rotating shaft. In a slide pot, it's fixed to a straight mechanical carriage that moves back and forth. This is the part you actually interact with, the knob you twist or the slider you push. Then there are three terminals or pins. The two outer pins are connected to the two ends of the resistive track. There is always a fixed resistance between these two. This is the rated resistance of the potentiometer. The middle pin is usually connected to the wiper. As the wiper moves, the resistance between the middle pin and each outer pin changes, but the sum of those two resistances always equals the total track resistance. When you use a potentiometer as a voltage divider, you normally connect one outer terminal to the positive supply and the other outer terminal to ground, and take your output voltage from the middle wiper pin. When you use it as a variable resistor or rheostat, you only use two pins, the wiper and one of the outer terminals. Often the unused outer terminal is tied to the wiper on the PCB to keep things stable if the wiper momentarily lifts. All of this is held together by the housing and the bushing. The housing protects the resistive element and wiper from dust and mechanical damage. The threaded bushing at the front lets you mount the potentiometer onto a panel or enclosure using a nut and washer. And finally, there's the taper. This isn't a separate part you can see, but rather how the resistance changes as the wiper moves. A linear taper changes resistance evenly across the whole movement, while an audio or logarithmic taper changes more slowly at one end and more rapidly at the other. Ideal for volume control because it matches how our ears perceive loudness. Different applications call for different tapers, so it's always worth checking the datasheet. Most potentiometers come in common values, like the following. Lower values draw more current, while very high values can introduce electrical noise. Choosing the right value depends on the circuit's current limits and the sensitivity you want. Types of potentiometers. Not all potentiometers look or behave the same way. Let's take a closer look at the main types you'll come across. Rotary potentiometer. This is the most common type of potentiometer, the classic knob you twist. The wiper travels along a circular resistive path, usually through around 270 degrees. These are found in audio gear, power supplies, instruments, and general electronics. Linear potentiometer, also known as slide pot. Instead of rotating, the wiper slides along a straight track. You'll see these in mixing desks, lighting controllers, and synthesizers. Ideal for intuitive linear adjustments. Digital potentiometer. No moving parts here. A digital pot uses internal resistor ladders and electronic switches to set resistance using digital signals. They're used in microcontroller-based systems for precise, programmable control, but typically can't handle the higher voltages or currents that mechanical pots can. Trimmer potentiometer, also known as trim pot. A small, adjustable potentiometer used for calibration inside circuits. They're often single-turn or multi-turn and are usually set once during manufacture or maintenance. Multi-turn potentiometer, designed for very fine adjustments. These require several full turns of the screw or knob to sweep the full resistance range. They're used in precision circuits and instrumentation. Wire-wound potentiometer. Some potentiometers use a fine resistive wire wound around a core. These can handle higher power and offer excellent precision, but the wiper steps across individual wire turns, so they don't give perfectly smooth changes and aren't ideal for audio. Potentiometer limitations. As with any component, potentiometers have their drawbacks. Mechanical wear from constant movement can create noise or scratchiness, and dust or humidity can interfere with the wiper's contact with the track. Over time, the contact resistance can drift, especially in low-cost carbon types. There are also low-powered devices, usually rated only for a fraction of a watt, so high current can easily damage the resistive track. And if the load connected to the wiper has too low a resistance, it can distort the voltage divider behavior and reduce accuracy. That's why digital or optical encoders are often replacing them in high precision and long life applications. If you enjoyed this video and learned something new, don't forget to subscribe to Engineeringness. Give us a thumbs up, check out our online store for unique engineering merch, and consider becoming a channel member to get early access to all our videos and behind-the-scenes animations. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one.